the class of 89. And in country music terms, the class of 89 basically is referring to four people. Those four people were Garth Brooks, Clint Black, Alan Jackson, and me. And let me tell you something, y'all. In that group of four that I just mentioned, I stuck out like a sore thumb. I did. Because those guys, they were all clean cut. They all wore starched, pressed cowboy shirts on stage. As a matter of fact, they did something I'd never seen before. They starched and pressed their blue jeans I'd never seen. And they all wore cowboy hats. I didn't. Not because I had anything against cowboy hats. Not at all. The way I felt about it back then was, look, I've got all my hair, why cover it up, you know? A lot of those guys couldn't say that. Like those guys were doing, there were a lot of people in Nashville, especially, that immediately labeled me as being something different because I was trying to combine not only the straight ahead country music that I grew up on, but I was trying to combine it with stuff like Lynyrd Skynyrd, Charlie Daniels, Hank Williams Jr., and the Allman Brothers. And there's a certain element in Nashville that did not like that at all. And they immediately started putting labels on me. And they said, well, you know what? This guy is a nonconformist. He's a Mustang. He's got that long hair down about right there. He wears a lot of leather. That was only because I was playing in biker bars and poop holes before I ever came to Nashville.